Hey everyone, Kevin here from Kramer Aerotow Team. We're going to do something different in this video. We're going to talk about GPS triangle racing. So first off, what is GPS triangle racing? It's a competition that we do at scale soaring events, and the goal is to fly as many laps around this triangle that you see in the bottom right of the screen here as possible in 30 minutes. So how do we do this? We've got a couple pieces of hardware. First, we've got a GPS unit that you can actually see just above the instrument panel in the video there. And then we have that sending information to Raven, which is mounted in the fuselage, which then sends information to Snipe, which is mounted to the back of my transmitter, and then displays all this information on an Android phone running an app called Albatross. Don't worry about following what all this is. I'm going to have links to all that in the video description. So Raven gives us a ton of information to work with. I've put the most important stuff on the screen. On the right side, you're going to see a map with my GPS position, little black glider moving around there. And on the bottom left, we've got our ground speed, our altitude above the ground, and our vario. You're going to see the tow get a little screwed up here as we come up on 500 meters, which is right where we want to be. So I'm going to release. So now we can start the task. We've got to cross the start-finish line at a maximum of 500 meters and a maximum speed of 120 kilometers an hour. So right now I'm just working my way towards the start side of the line. So we're crossing the line here onto the start side. And now I'm going to turn around and you'll see I'm at about just over 500 meters. So I'm going to push the nose down to get a little speed up. And then I decide I'm probably going too fast, and I pitch back up to try to slow down, and I stall it and lose a bunch of altitude. I have not gotten the hang of starting yet, but we cross the line at, I think that said 40 kilometers an hour, and just under 500 meters. This is where it gets kind of fun. So we're going to head towards the first turn point, and you're going to see that even though I screwed up here at the start, my altitude, you can see the vario is positive and my altitude's going up. By the time I get to turn point one, I am like back up above 500 meters, which for me is a fantastic start to this session. This day was pretty challenging because there was a really strong headwind blowing from turn point one in the top left to turn point three in the bottom right. So you'll see I've got the glider trimmed for about 60 to 70 kilometers an hour, and you'll see my ground speed drop as low as 25-30 when I'm trying to push to the north there. So you're gonna see me grab the turn point here and get back to right around 550 meters, and then I decide I know this thermal is hanging right at turn point one, which is pretty far upwind, so I'm gonna go see if I can knock out a lap, come back and meet up with this thermal again. So hopefully I can get a lap in the books and not really have it cost me anything. So you can see we're going right around 100 kilometers an hour downwind here, headed towards turn point two. And you're gonna see with this much wind, I really overshoot this this turn. I go way too far out and way too far south of the turn point here. So it's going to take even more altitude for me to get back here. But you see, we're still above 500 meters and headed toward turn point three. This leg from turn point two to three was real rough. It seemed like there was always sink here. So you'd end up losing a bunch of altitude at turn point three, and then you've got to make this left turn into the wind. So now you're slow and losing altitude. It was really frustrating. So we're going to hit turn point three here. Hope I don't miss it. Nope, there we go. All right, so we hit turn point three and turn into the wind here. This is where you're going to see the ground speed drop. We're just under 500 meters now, and we're headed back towards the pink start-finish line to finish our first lap. So this is one of the things I really need to work on. If you look closely, you can kind of tell this this long leg that we're on now, it kind of goes directly over our heads. And getting used to flying any airplane directly over your head, let alone one that's at almost 500 meters above you, is really challenging. So you're going to see me swing way wide here. And watching this back, I'm shocked at how far out I am, just because I wanted to be able to see what the airplane was doing. But we're going to finish lap one here. So now this is where I think that I'm going to head back to that thermal that we found at turn point one on the first lap. But if you've been watching the Vario, you saw as much as 4 meters per second as we came across the start line. So I didn't realize that the thermal had drifted that far. So I'm going back to where I think it is, but really the best lift is behind me. There's definitely going to be a little bit of lift here, and it's going to keep me probably right at right under 500 meters, I think. But it's not like it was before, and I remember being pretty confused as to why it was so weak now when it was so strong earlier, and I'm thinking I'm back in it. So I grab turn point one again and decide, well, I'm going to go get another lap out of this. So we turn downwind again, headed toward turn point two. At this point, even though my plan to get back into that thermal didn't pan out, I'm still pretty happy. I'm basically right around 500 meters and got one lap in the books. Looking to do a second one here. It's really the best start I've had all weekend. So we're going to grab turn point two here and head towards turn point three again. Same thing with that big headwind. I'm going to end up way wide, but still feeling good. Still at just under 500 meters, headed for turn point three. Let's see. This time the sink is way worse here. It was showing 3 meters per second down there. So I think maybe I'm trying to fly faster to get out of it. I might have gotten something on the Vario. So we're going to grab turn point three and then make this slow turn. This is agonizingly slow run back to the start-finish line. It'll be interesting to see where that thermal is now, or if I ever find it again. Let's see if we can find it. So here's two and a half. That's probably it. It was at turn point one on the first lap, about the start finish line on the second lap, or as we finished the first lap, and now as we're coming around on the second lap, it's closer to turn point three. So really we're just in a bunch of sink. I'm still swinging out wide here. But hey, I got two laps, so man, that is a lot of sync we're getting, and we're going slow. So now at this point, I'm really just hoping maybe wherever that thermal was generated, maybe the next one in the cycle is coming. So spoilers for the end of the video, I did not find the next thermal that was generated. But we're going to head over here to turn point one. I believe this is Kanyo ahead of me and to the right that you see. He's flying either his Antares or his Ventus. I'm flying my third scale 6 meter KV models Shark. It's a really awesome airplane. I let it down on a regular basis when it comes to GPS racing. Oh, so this is where things start to go awry. If you look closely, you can see I missed the turn point there. I turned just inside it, and I need to make a 270 here to come back around and hit it, and then start this run down to turn point two. Man, still getting a lot of sink. Another 3 meters per second down there. one of the pieces of information that Albatross can give you after your flight is tells you how much altitude you gained or lost on each lap. And I pulled that up as we're doing this downwind leg here. So on lap one, I actually gained 14 meters, which sounds about right. On lap two, I lost 50 meters. And now that we're coming around on lap three, just passing turn point two, by the time we finish, we'll have lost 154 meters. So really, this is where it kind of gets ugly. I missed that turn point. This leg is looking better, though. I'm in a little bit tighter and kind of tracking a little more straight. You know, not quite on the line, but doing better. The other piece of information that this gives me is it's called my index. So if I flew an entire lap right on the triangle, the index would be 100. And I'll put this information up on the screen so you guys can see it. On the first lap, my index was 138. And on the next two and three, 121. So you can see that I was flying a better course on the next two laps than I was on the first lap. So we're coming up on the end of lap three here, crossing the line, doing a little better this time, not going quite as far out. Comparing the map to the video, I can actually tell I'm pointed more at the turn point this time. At this point, we've gone from 500 meters down to 250. We lost, what do we say, about 150 meters that last lap. So I'm kind of in prayer mode here. I'm really hoping that there's something, another thermal drifting this direction. So I'm just kind of hanging here, going slow, hoping that I'm going to find something so that I can stretch a couple more laps out of this. Little bit of zero sync there, but I really need to grab the turn point first. Looks like I missed the turn point again, so I've got to come back around, and you can see I'm just spending more time here, losing altitude. We're down to 200 meters now. So, alright, let's try another downwind run here to turn point two. This time, way inside the triangle. Little bit of lift here, mostly zero sync, a little bit of lift, but it seems like every time I turn, the lift goes away. It's not particularly strong. So same plan here, let's go grab the turn point and then see if we can pick up anything. So actually, there was a little bit of lift there. I think, yep, I made a turn back to try to get in this. The only problem with this, I remember thinking it and doing it now, is that I'm still downwind. So as I'm circling in this, the wind is pushing me further from the course. And I realize that right away. Like, even if there's lift here, I'm not going to get anything out of it because I'm just going to end up further away from the course. So I start heading down the ridge to turn point three. Again, little pockets of lift. Not even lift, but zero sync. But nothing that's really gonna stretch this flight much longer. Even if I do find some lift here, it doesn't really help me because I'm not gonna gain anything out of it. All right, so now we're headed back upwind. Got a nice shot of the field there. This is probably my best track yet. We'll see if I end up turning, flying over our heads or turning out towards the right again. no, this is looking much better. I think this is because I'm lower and it's easier to see and I'm a little more comfortable, able to track better. But even here, I'd make a turn out to the right a little bit. Still getting into some sync, not finding lift. It's four laps down though. This is my best session of the weekend. Really hoping I can squeeze one more lap out of it. So we're gonna point it towards a little bit more towards turn point three. Nothing yet. Down to 150 meters. Still hoping for that big thermal to roll through and save this flight, but haven't found anything, and with this much wind, it's pretty tough. Down to under 120 meters. So I figure my best bet is to grab this turn point and run down to turn point two and just hope I find something along the way to let me pick this up. I'm trying to fly straight down the line, you know, using as little altitude as I can to get there. I think I'm flying a little bit slow. I think I could be going a little faster, but I don't think it's gonna matter here. As I get out here, I'm still in sync, managed to grab the turn point, and now we're down to 80 meters. And I start to head to turn point three, and you can already see the ridge and the runway are right there. I'm just gonna have to bail and point it at the runway. I don't think, with this much headwind, I don't think I used any flaps for this approach. I just pushed the nose down, kept the speed up, and headed for the runway. There was one spot where I got a little bit slow trying to bring it in here, but mostly it was a pretty stable approach. As I say that, I'm getting knocked around by the wind. Ouch. Not the best landing. But right back at my feet, and four laps. So hopefully this video gave you a good idea what GPS triangle racing is about. It's kind of an abstract thing to talk about, and I think having a video and seeing it in action really helps. For me, I learned a bunch from rewatching this. The big thing was looking at my track and realizing how far away from the course I actually was. That hurt me a lot. Not recognizing when I was in lift, I think my plan would have worked. That thermal that I snagged at the beginning, when I found it again, when I finished that lap, it was still really strong as I flew through it. I think I could have gained probably at least another 50 meters hanging out in it. That and not missing my turn point twice, I think would have netted me at least another lap and a half. So I think I could have ended up at 5.5 or 6. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. It's something different, something I'd like to do more of. Let me know if it's something you'd like to see. Otherwise, thanks for watching.